back and finish the projects that are on the table right now, and that's Chinatown, the LSL Marketplace, and Central Salinas. So that is my, you know, we need to finish what we started. So I support you on that. So again, in that, I support the committee, whatever we want to call the committee, but I would also like to see diversity in that committee that is going to be established, that you include the businesses, but also include, you know, community members.
Thank you, Gloria. Tony?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I think even though it's a study session and it's a long period of time of good work here, I think we've had some good community discussion today. People from the entire city are here today, and we've heard some good comments. I think one of the concerns that I have, and again, not to minimize the work of the staff, because I think they're doing a great job, but the Alisal has not had its fair share of redevelopment. Regardless of what the reason is, if you go look, physically go look at that side of town, we have not had our fair share of redevelopment. And I think the money that comes from that area should be taken into serious consideration. As we develop the infrastructure, you can tell several years ago on 1st, 2nd Avenue, Aquila, they fixed up the streets, which they did a great job. Once the streets were getting fixed, people were investing in their homes. They started fixing up their homes. You go look at that neighborhood, it's a beautiful neighborhood. Really nice houses. You look at East Market right now with the infrastructure of our new street, there are businesses already paving in their new parking lots. Facades, new facades are coming up. That restores pride, the image of the community. And I think right now, my biggest concern in this town, and yeah, every part of the city needs attention, but there is no reason why people have to live in dilapidated conditions such as you call it, East Salinas. We have thousands of children that live in apartments that should be torn down right now and somehow be fixed up. We do have some developers that have looked at the situation and they're in agreement, but they're looking for money. Money is always the issue. But I think even though as we're going into this study session, I don't believe in creating more work. I believe in creating smart work. If we're listening already, we've been involved in a lot of community meetings. And if we really listen to the people, they really, whatever we started now, whether it's here in Old Town Salinas, we've had a lot of conversation, a lot of work has gone into Old Town Salinas, and for some reason we can't get our finger on the issue, how to start development, how to break ground. So I think it's important, the comments that were brought up today, I think those are critical. And what I keep hearing from several people here is, whatever we are starting, whatever we've planned already, let's finish the process. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Tony. I think arguably this could be the most important discussion this council has as a group. One of the things I occasionally think about is, whoever sits on this dais and succeeds all of us 10, 20, 30 years from now, if they were to look back and say, okay, this council had in front of them a tool to do the most important thing it could do at this time, at this place, at this juncture in this city's history to address all the concerns we had, which is a tool that allows us to attract investment. That in fact is the most critical thing we have to do, because indeed if we're in a new era that we must live within our means, then we must create the possibility of expanding our means. And the simple fact is that financial strength and financial capacity and redevelopment is the fundamental tool that does that, and that coupled with the enterprise zone and some of the other good work we've done allows us to, as it were, shape the economic battlefield for success on a go-forward basis. And so some of the concerns we've heard tonight is, and I think Councilmember Sanchez said it well, and I think Alan laid out a series of accomplishments, and indeed I can point out to what has happened while we've been on council, that when we're organized, that when we're focused around a critical objective, whether it's the future growth area, whether it's Unicool, we organize and we get it done. So I'm confident we can organize and get this done, and I believe we need to do this. If we don't do this, and this is a lengthy process, and this is the beginning of the road, we run the risk of continued near-term stagnation, because the reality is the capital markets are frozen. We need to create the possibility of access to capital. And I have confidence that through a very extensive community dialogue, and I want to point out for the record, that redevelopment discussions have already taken place publicly, transparently. County Chair Supervisor Salinas and I stood in this room in early February and laid that out publicly. It has been in several written documents that I've been involved. We are hiding in plain sight on this issue. And we fully understand that unless there is community buy-in, it simply can't go forward. I mean, there is no place to hide on this. We must aggressively reach out to the public to create buy-in and make the case that in order for Salinas to address all its issues and create all its opportunities that we all want, we simply need financial tools to do this. And I'm confident and I'm optimistic. You know, the one thing I think we can all observe about Salinas, you know, when we have a dialogue, they get pretty spirited sometimes. But you know, we get through them. And the interesting thing about the marketplace will tell you what its priorities are, where it's willing to invest, not willing to invest. So for instance, if we just simply take the Alisal marketplace, you know, there are some developers who are pretty darn stubborn about the future of Salinas. They believe in it, and they think the Alisal marketplace, those 52 acres, is X marks the spot. And I think Tony and Sergio and Gloria, all of you have brought up this notion of, hey, let's think a little bit more residentially. What a great, this is the type of tool that gets us there. So one of the things I like about this council is it changed the dynamic of, hey, if we just put a hotel in the 100 block, it'll all come rushing back, to let's think bigger, let's think about the whole downtown, let's think about an inner zone, let's enterprise zone, let's work with our valley cities, let's be together, let's think regionally. And as Councilmember Sanchez pointed out a couple sessions ago, inevitably the agreement to do this leads to the next step, which is whatever our version of this is. You know, in San Jose they do 2040. I'm absolutely confident I won't live that long, so I don't like the idea of Salinas 2040. I think we ought to tighten it up. But it does lead inevitably to that master plan, to coming together as a community, to setting priorities. So I think this is pretty exciting how we've evolved as a council and as a community to do all this stuff. And make no mistake, I think this is really exciting. This will be the hardest, the risk reward in order to get these rewards. This will arguably be the hardest thing we've undertaken as a city, particularly in this day and age, to get it done. But I think we absolutely have to move in this direction. If the community is not interested, so be it. But I think sometimes when we as a council have, and this is the privilege we have as being public servants, is we do get to see a lot of information, and we need to listen. But we also, you know, I've heard clearly from the public, live within your means. And that's okay. But then I also want to say clearly back, then we need to expand our means. We got it. But then we need some tools to do what you need done, because I have not heard from the public, we want less stuff. We're interested in being safer a little further down the line, as opposed to sooner down the line. Got it. But if we're gonna live within our means, we gotta begin to take the steps to expand our means. So it's kind of a beautiful spring night. We don't have as many people as when we started. But this is, I think, a pretty important discussion on behalf of the community, and starts a real important process. So I am delighted to hear the type of support from the council that should be there, that we like it, we have some concerns, the public has some concerns, and that tells me we're in for a great deliberative process, and I'm confident we're going to get the right outcome, whatever that is. And for what it's worth, I will share this in closing. When I did sit in that meeting, and Alan, and when I was introduced, she looked at me and said, "So how much of the city do you want to put in the redevelopment area?" And I said, "All of it." And Alan metaphorically reached over and handed her a buck and said, "I told you you'd say that." So the point is, you know, I really think this is a tremendous tool, a tremendous opportunity, and I'm really confident we can work through the issue of priorities, because the reality is, one of the reasons we haven't moved as fast is because we haven't had the financial strength to punch it through, to do things other than incremental projects. The way to finish is to have real capacity to get this one done and go on to the next one. We're kind of in that tweener phase. This helps break that cycle. So I think this is a really important conversation. I think it's an extraordinary report. I agree with Alan, you and Don and your group have done a really nice job, and your ability to answer questions and master technical information is to be admired, and I think will be a great asset to the community as we go through this process, as I hope we will. So I appreciate that. If there is a motion to provide direction to staff to move forward, I'll entertain that.
So moved. Second.
Okay, we're fighting over first and seconds. So that's good. And with that, we will go ahead and call for the question. I'll get a clarification of what the actual motion is.
You've just provided direction. I really don't think there's any action.
I like calling for the question. It's fun.
I know you do.
All right, we won't call for the question.
It's not on the agenda, so there's no question to
that.
Be called.
All right. With that, we're going into closed session and talk about stuff that only we can know about for a while. All right. See you next Tuesday.